Hi, my name is Kwaku Rogers, and welcome to another Intro to R video, where we'll be focusing on loading and saving datasets in R. Datasets that you work with at the Spec Lab can come in different file types. We'll be focusing on how to load RData, RDS, and CSV files. RData and RDS are both file types to store R output or objects. The main difference between these two is that RDS files are only one object and RData files are larger and can store multiple objects. The key thing to take away is that different file types may require different read-in functions. On line 32, I'm loading in the productive pacifist dataset, which is an RData file. This was real replication data for a paper published in the International Studies Quarterly. I'm loading this in from my training data August 2021 folder from my working directory. To access training data from the Spec Lab, head towards uscspec.org/training-data. Now, using the load function, I'm referencing the exact name of the dataset that I'm working with, surrounded by quotations. After running line 32, the dataset loads into the local environment as an object named that. To view the dataset, on line 35, we use the view function. In R, R is case sensitive. So typing view command with a lowercase v instead of a uppercase v will not work in RStudio. So remember to always type the function correctly. After running line 35, RStudio opens a new tab depicting the dataset. Another shortcut instead of typing the view command is to click on the local environment inside the object itself. Now, after reviewing this dataset, the data is structured into rows and columns. So how big is the data set? How many rows and columns are there? To do this, we need to use two functions, the nrow and the ncol functions. After running the nrow function on the data set, the console returns 15,599 rows. On line 41, ncol returns 33 columns on the dataset, which corresponds to the observations and variables listed in the global environment. All right, so let's imagine when I've manipulated this dataset and created some new object, I want to save it as a file. On line 44, the save function allows me to save my new dataset, referencing the name of the object and the file name that I want it to be called. In addition to this, I want to make sure that my training output is separate from my training data that I have downloaded already. So I've created a training output folder to make sure that my new dataset is in a different folder inside my training directory folder that I've already set up. Moving on, another dataset type we'll work with is RDS. RDS files require the readRDS command. Now, just as I've mentioned before, R is case sensitive, so remember to type the function correctly. The difference with the readRDS function, after running line 47, the data set is loaded onto the console. It's not loaded onto the local environment. To fix this, we need to assign an object to the readRDS function. On line 50, I've assigned the milex object to the readRDS function. After running line 50, the milex will appear in the local environment. This data represents military expenditures in countries around the world. Now, just like we did in line 44, you use the save function on line 62 to save your milex object. Now, another data set you'll work with in the Spec Lab is the CSV file, or the comma separated values. I'm using survey data from the Lewis registry project. There is a read.csv command that comes with base R, and that works fine, though in the lab we prefer to use the read_csv command from the readr package. This command is a bit more efficient, which matters if you're reading in really large datasets. I can use the read underscore CSV command to load the dataset and save it as an object in my environment. Note that the read underscore CSV command only works if you've installed the readr package and loaded that package in using the library command. I used the write underscore CSV function to save my CSV, which is also underneath the readr package. And the syntax is similar to the save function. Usually when we're working in the lab, we save data in the RDS format, but sometimes it is nice to save as CSV, since CSV is a format that can be easily read by a wide range of software, including Excel. In our next intro to R video, we'll focus on creating and manipulating vectors.